So the next option which we have is the next shortcut key range which we have is from F1 to F12. Now these are to be used alone without control or without alt keys. So alone you are going to press F1 and you get this particular shortcut. So these are the alone keys, and why do I call it alone? Because you don't have to use it with shift, control or alt or any other keys. So what do I do is I'll click on F1 and I get the help tab. So I just click on F1 and you get this window, Excel help, and you can search for any function or any feature you want to, and you get the entire list. So this is how you get the help tab, F1. F2 is the edit mode. What do I mean by edit mode is that when I am on a particular cell, there are two ways. Suppose I need to edit this Tuesday as Tuesday 2, or maybe anything I want to write after Tuesday, or basically I want to edit this. So what do I do is I double click and I get this cursor over here, and I can just simply add change or whatever things I want to, I can. Or what is the shortcut for this? So just take your cursor wherever you want to, and you just need to click on F2 and you get this cursor, and you can just type in whatever things you want to type in the cell. So this is how you go to the edit mode by clicking on the F2. The next option we have, the F3, which is the paste name formula. Now what do I mean by this is, suppose I have taken this entire name, this entire cells, and renamed this as days. So I've taken these cells and I've renamed it as days. So when I go to this corresponding cell over here and I click on F3, I get something as paste name option over here. And when I select days and I click on the OK, so what it does, it asks me equal to days. So then I hit enter and I get Monday over here. So exactly same again when I do this days, OK, and it gives me Tuesday. So this is how you can fill up all your cells in the corresponding column. Basically when you do it for here, basically after, so these were the ranges I renamed as days, right? Now I'm taking my cursor over here, which is in row number 41. So when I click on F3 again and I select days and I click on OK, enter, so you get a value error over here. This is only because in this particular area, which is exactly corresponding to the named range, because these were the cells I had renamed to days. So exactly corresponding cells only you can use this F3 formula or the paste name formula which we have. You can't use it anywhere else. So if I use it here, again I'll get the same issue. Again I'll get the error and you get this value error. So this only works out, the F3 paste name formula only works out to the corresponding cell ranges in which you have done your or written your named range or just selected your named range. So that is how it works for the paste name formula. This is basically done when you let's say suppose you have a very huge table with many number of columns. So you have seen many times that the first column and the last column you have in the table are the same, so that it's easier for you all to trace it through the columns. You may have 15-20 columns, so the first column and the very last columns are mostly same. It can be your roll number, it can be your name, anything else. So that is when you use this days or the paste name formula. Basically then we have the F4, which is repeat action. Basically now what this means is that if I copy Wednesday and I paste it somewhere over here, and let me take my cursor to somewhere else and click on F4, the moment I click on F4, it pastes my value again over here. So basically what it does, it repeats your action, but it will only repeat your action for once. So again, if I click on F4, see, I'm clicking on F4 and nothing is happening because it repeats the action only one time. So again, if I copy some other thing over here and paste it over here and maybe take Control C and I'm pasting it over here, and you can take your cursor somewhere else and click on F4, so it repeats the action. So whatever you have done in the very last time, the whatever action you have performed the very last moment will be repeated when you click on F4. So this is how it works out. Next we have the F5, which is again the go-to shortcut which we have. So I click on F5 and you get this go-to dialog box. So you can go to this named range which I have, or you can go to any other cells you want to specify. F7, so it takes you to F7. So this is how the F5 works out. The next we have is F6, which is the next pane. Now what do I mean by next pane is that if I take my cursor to, let's say, suppose somewhere very distant, and I'm here currently, I'm in this particular pane. So when I click on F6, what it does, it basically can just look at over here on the toolbar section, F6. So it selects this first and then it selects the upper section. So just keep a check on the status bar, and on the tabs section over here which we have. So when I click on F6, this gets selected first of all, F6, and it's basically like Alt. When you use Alt and you select all these options over here, so it's exactly like Alt. See, so this is how it works out. It's exactly like Alt, what Alt does, F6. Yeah, the difference being that in Alt you can just select the tab section in one go. In F6, what happens that it first selects the status bar and then it moves on. So if you have something going on in the status bar, currently I don't have anything going on in my status bar, so nothing is being selected. If you have anything going on in the status bar, so that will be selected and then this particular pane will be selected. So it's the next pane option basically. So these are the two panes we are talking about. So see, so this is how it works. The next we have the F7, which is the spell check. So if I click on F7, I get this dialog box saying, do you want to continue checking at the beginning of the sheet? So it will take you to the very beginning and it will go one by one in one cell and it will check your all the spellings. So I click on yes. So it checks, okay, January, this is not in dictionary. So do you want to ignore once? Do you want to add this to the dictionary? So these are the suggestions which you have got. I'll click on maybe cancel. And so this is basically the spell check option which you get. So again, when I click on F7, I'll click on ignore once. We have many Januaries over here, so it's keep on repeating because I had written many Januaries. You can see my cursor is over here currently. So it goes, it checks all the Januaries together and then it will move on to the next section. So next we have this go to. Do you want to change this? I'll just click on maybe. So wherever, whatever words which are not added to my dictionary will be the cells which will be highlighted, and then will be asked that whether you want to change the spelling or you want to ignore it or you want to add it to your dictionary. And it gives you many suggestions over here as well. So I'll just click on ignore once. And that is how you use the spell check option. So the next we have the extend. So F7 is the spell check. Next we have the expand selection, which is very simple and very interesting to use. So if I take my cursor over here anywhere and click on F8. So I've pressed F8. Now I'll just use my single hand and I'll use the arrow keys. I'm not using my mouse. My mouse is here. So I'm not using my mouse. I need to select this entire table. So what I'll do is, I have clicked on F8, I'll just click on the right arrow. See, this, you have this option called extend selection over here. The moment you click on F8, you have this extend selection option over here. So I'm not using my mouse, I'm just using the arrow keys, the up, down, right, left arrow keys. Right, and it got selected, down, 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 up 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 up. So this is how you can extend your selections, and you can use just single hand, and you can use just four arrow keys to make an entire selection. You don't have to click on control shift down arrow, or you don't have to use the control or the shift options over here. You just need a single hand and you can just click on the arrow keys which you have, and you have this extend selection option over here. You can do the same thing when you are outside the table. So you, when you want to remove this extend selection option, because see, wherever I am clicking, it's basically getting selected. So you need to remove this. For that, again you'll click on F8. So the moment you click on F8, I clicked on F8 and this is gone. So here we are, F8. See, you again have this option of extend selection. Again you can extend it. So this is how you use your extend selection option. Again I'll click on F8 and now this is gone. The next we have is F9, which is calculate all. So basically what happens in Excel is that whenever you make any calculations, it gets automatically calculated. But what I've currently done is that if I calculate the sum of these numbers, then I have the value of 280, right? So this has been performed. But now if I make any changes, suppose I make this 30 as a 300, see, no change have been made because I have made my workbook to a manual calculation. I've changed the settings basically. So you go to the file section over here and you go to the options, and in the options we have, in the formulas option over here, in the formulas we have something under the calculation options as manual. So it's not automatic for me now. Basically it remains automatic. The default selection is automatic. I've made this manual for the time being for you all to understand. So basically what does this manual means is that until and unless I go to my formula section over here and I click on the calculate now option, it will not calculate. The answer will not get updated. Or what I can do is I can just click on F9 and it will perform all the calculations in my sheet in one go. So I click on F9 and see, this has been changed. Again I'll show you all if I make this 100 and nothing happened, but when I click on F9, see, the calculation has been performed. So this is how, either you can click on F9, which is the shortcut for calculate all, or you can go to the formulas and you have this calculate now option over here. So that is how you do the calculate. You use the F9 shortcut key. Then we have the F10, which is the activate menu. So what is this activate menu which I'm talking about? Okay, one more shortcut which I can show you all over here is that instead of the sum function, what shortcut you can use is you can just simply click on alt equal to is basically the shortcut for the sum function. So what it does is it gives me the equal to sum and it selects all these cells at one go, and you can just click on enter. So alt and equal to, so you use this shortcut key for getting the sum over here, sum function over here. Next we have the activate menu. So what is activate menu basically? I click on F10. It's basically again like the alt we have done. I click on F10 and we have the menu section. So this is the menu section. What is the difference between the activate menu and the next pane section is that basically the next pane means all these are the panes. Suppose this spreadsheet is a pane, this menu section is a pane, and this status bar is a pane. So when you click on F6, it moves on to the next pane. And so if it's in the status bar, if it's in the menu bar, it will go on to the status bar. If it's in the status bar, it will go on to the menu bar. So that is how you work out F6. Whereas F10, which is the activate menu, is exactly like the alt. You just click on F10 and the menu section is activated. Just exactly what happens with the alt. F6 is a little different from F10. F6 is the next pane section. So if you have your cursor somewhere else, what it does, it takes you there. F6, if I click on F6, it takes me to the status bar first. So you can see this has been selected. I'll just give you all one more hint. Just look at over here, in the expand my workbook zoom out and zoom in options. Just have a look over here, and when I click on F6, this plus sign has been selected on its own. Why? Because I am in the status bar. And again, when I click on F6, now this has been selected. Again, when I click on F6, this spreadsheet has been selected. Again, I click on F6 and we have this plus sign selected. So basically, it's fine. The next pane is, we are talking about the two panes, which is the status bar and the menu section. So it goes between these two. The next we have the activate, we have done activate menu option. Then we have the new chart. So if I take my cursor over here and I click on F11, it gives me a new chart, but the new chart is selected. Okay, I'll just go back and I'll just make a few changes. I'll just delete these. Okay, so now let us just go here and I'll just delete this sheet for once. And I click on F11, so it gives me a new chart. The chart opens up in a new sheet. And also the Excel selects the most suitable chart for you. So it can be a column chart or a pie chart, depending. Generally selects the column and the bar charts. So it has selected this, it has made this chart for me in the new tab, in a new sheet itself, not in the same sheet, but in a new sheet over here. So this is how you use the F11 option to create a new chart. Next we have the save as option, which is F12. So I click on F12 and it gives me a save as dialog box. Now this is not exactly similar to Control S, because Control S will save your work. And if only you are doing it in your new workbook, then it will give you the save as option. But F12 will give you the exact save as dialog box, and you can save the entire workbook wherever you want to. If you want to create a copy in exact same place, you can do that. So these were the shortcut keys which we have seen for F11 from F1 to F12. Thank you.